Lyndon, hello, how are you doing?
Fine, thanks. Hello.
Thanks for granting this interview to Domain.info.
I'm Patrick Lyndon. I'm currently communications manager at Jurid, who operates the .eu TLD. I used to work with .se before, the Swedish CCTLD. I have a background in PR and communications and journalism, and I got interested in internet, and that way I got close to the domain world, and then I got to work for .se and from there to .eu. And .se is also one of the founders of .eu, so it was a kind of natural step to take. We are quite pleased with things for the moment. We've been growing quite rapidly, I would say. We now have 2.6 million domain names, more than ever before. And we have quite a healthy growth. And we see now, we have been around for, 1.5 years, you could say, in the public domain. And we see that the domain names are picking up. We have a good number of domain names, but also the usage is now starting. Because it takes some time for people to get, when they register a domain name before they actually use it in public, in advertising and on their corporate website, etc. But now you can see EU domain names being advertised for companies. When I was flying here, I saw in the in-flight magazine a number of .eu domain names advertised, and you start seeing it everywhere now. So we really feel like the usage is picking up. So we have the COCs, the code of conduct, and we have set up a code of conduct for .eu registrars. So, because there are a lot of things in the, let's say, the contract with the registrars that's hard to put in there, that you want for behavior and you want best-in-class service from registrars, and that is sometimes difficult to define legally in a contract. So instead, we have this voluntary code of conduct program. And currently, we have between 55 and 60 registrars that signed this or subscribe to the code of conduct. So we see that as a, let's say, as a way of informing the consumers or the registrants, so they can see if they want to choose a registrar, that they can choose one that has subscribed to code of conduct. We have been looking at other code of conducts, of course, and then we've created our own. .asia, of course, have been interested in what we've been doing since we have a very similar setup, you could say, or in part similar at least. So they have been asking us how we did things and have been studying what we've been doing. And we'd be quite happy to assist them or tell them what we've been doing. We had a friendly relationship, but it's completely different, of course. It's a different geographical region, so there's no competition in that way. And also, I think that .asia shows rather a growing interest in regional domain names. So you can see that people have an interest in showing the regional identity rather than the national identity or something else. So I think there will be different people using it, of course, different regions, but there's a trend you can see. Europe is first, now it's .asia. I know there's interest from other regions as well. I think both Africa and South America are interested in getting a TLD. And I think that is part of the same trend. People are traveling more, doing more business across borders, they have friends everywhere. The national borders are not so important anymore, and I think that is why there's a bigger interest in regional TLDs. And for Europe it's easier, of course, because you have the European Union already in place. I think the .eu as an extension of the common market. It's a digital extension of the common market. We deal with our registrars and our registrants, and so we're not really into the second market. It's outside of our domain, so to speak, or our what we do. So if someone wants to give away domain name or sell it, it's up to them. It's between the buyer and the seller or whoever receives it. So it's not anything that Jurid is concerned with in that sense. So we don't really have a strong opinion on that. As long as the person owning the domain name or the registrant is from within the European Union, not necessarily a citizen, but they have to reside within the European Union as an organization, company or private person. We are running .eu with a contract from the European Commission, so I don't want to speak on their behalf, but I know they're represented in the GAC, and we are represented in the CC. We are taking part in the CCNSO meetings, so we definitely have a representation within the ICANN community. The United States have a history in this, of course, and it's very different that way. And also for the EU is quite new in this game. So I can see it's naturally a difference, but you really have to talk to the European Commission about what they think on that. No, but I could say, I don't know if it's breaking news, but we could say that we have introduced the dynamic updates. So now if you change your domain name, If you register domain name, it goes live within seconds. Instead, before it used to be 5 times a day. So, and also if you do changes, if you transfer domain name, it goes live immediately. So you can have your own .eu website or email service up within a few seconds. That's happened in 9th of October, so it's quite new. And also we are now preparing for IDNs, since we have 27 countries and 23 languages, it's quite a big thing. So we hope to be able to announce how we're going to do this shortly, and in a way so that we can handle all the languages of the European Union. Well, that's what we're working on right now, so I cannot say exactly what will happen. Well, we haven't decided yet exactly what's going to happen, but that shortly we will be able to tell that. Personally, I don't think so. I mean, the IDNs have been around for quite some time. We're talking about the normal IDNs, not the dot IDN. But the normal IDN has been there for a number of years, I don't remember how many, yeah, and still it works quite fine, technically. Still, though, there is an issue with the browsers and email clients, which we cannot really do anything about for the moment. But I think it will take some time before it really takes off in usage. But since it's technically possible, I think we should be able to offer it to the registrants, and then it's up to the registrants to decide whether it's interesting or not. And it's not such a, maybe not such a big issue for people with Latin alphabets, but in our case we have, for instance, Bulgaria with Cyrillic alphabets, and for them I guess it's a bigger point in having IDN. We definitely want to increase usage. Now we have quite a big number of domain names. We are the third largest European TLD. We intend to continue to grow in numbers, but also especially in usage. We want to see .eu in the public space. I mean, you want to see addresses on the side of buses, or you see, so it becomes a natural part of the digital environment. Because we're getting there slowly, or well, I wouldn't say slowly, but we're getting there now. You start seeing it, but I think for next year, I think will be really a breakthrough when you start seeing .eu domain names everywhere.
Patrick, thank you very much for sharing your time with Domain.info.
Yep, thank you.